Well, we are on the road. We're here in Portage Lakes at Ghoul Brothers Haunted House. And the creator here is David Barton, and he has got some serious chops when it comes to special effects and makeup and all that stuff. You started in Hollywood, and you've done quite a few movies and things like that. What made you come back home?
I came back to Ohio to raise my family. I didn't want to raise them in Los Angeles. It's as lucrative and fun as Los Angeles is, it just wasn't the best spot to raise young kids. So we moved back for that and family.
This is a permanent structure here in the plaza, but you know, where did it all come from when you started this journey?
Well, that's a good question. You know, with my background in film and just different interests, ever since I was a young boy, I liked haunted houses. I liked the Disney Haunted Mansion,
yes,
stuff like that. I had visited a few haunted houses when I was younger. So I guess it just came from inside my mind and on a piece of paper and started drawing it out and figuring out scenes. And when I first started doing it, I sort of had one idea where I wanted to go. And then as we got closer to finishing, that changed a little bit here and there. Some of it, I've been collecting like different props and stuff from garbage dumps and sides of roads and antique shops for 20 years. And so at a certain point when you're designing a scene, you kind of look at what do we have a lot of? What do we have that will fit a certain, you know, motif or whatever for a room?
What is the most frightening thing? Unexpectedness? Gore? What do you think?
Yeah, it's usually in a haunted house. It's always what they call the jump scare, where somebody just jumps out and scares you. But that's kind of like the low-hanging fruit.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's like you can, you know, anyone can do that. You know, you're just in a dark spot, you jump out. So we try to add in the creepiness factor. You know, we try to have the sets that give a certain feel or a certain psychological idea behind it that hopefully, you know, there's certain things I think that people read a certain way. So we try to build it up to just have an overall feel that will add to the creepiness. And there's some people that will just never be scared. You know, they'll come through, they'll just laugh and have fun. So kind of our motto is if we can't scare them, at least entertain them, you know, amuse them.
Yeah.
But, you know, there's things that scare me. I mean, there's stuff, there's scenes and things that
what
just
scares
from childhood.
You? Yeah, that's a good question.
What scares me? canned goods that have gone bad, you know? It's like, that scares me, you know? So I have a film I directed, yeah, Bad Vegetation. Just from something as a child, I didn't eat any, but I was in an old decrepit house and we would take the cans off shelves. The house was crumbling, but the lady had done a lot of canning and we would take the cans and throw them and they would just kind of explode because they were full of gas and stuff like that. So that's scary to me, and I try to incorporate jars in some of the scenes and stuff. And
so where do you draw your inspiration?
You know, it's hard to say. I've certainly read a lot of like horror books. I've seen a lot of movies. I've read a lot of magazines, worked on a lot of film sets. And you know, Stephen King, people ask him, where does he get his ideas from, you know?
Yeah.
And he says they're just in the air floating around and he's just able to funnel them in. So I don't have any better answer than that, honestly.
Yeah.
You know, I had a regular childhood. I had normal parents, normal upbringing.
Yes.
So I'm not sure where exactly it came from, but I just observe a lot of things in life. And I guess ultimately they collect together and eventually it formed something. So that's about the best I can say.
What movies that you've done, what do you think are some of your better special effects?
Well, there's better movies and then there's better effects. So some of my better movies would be like the Usual Suspects, Starship Troopers.
Yeah.
I worked on a lot of different things, but it's hard.
Suspects.
Yeah, Usual Suspects was a really, it doesn't have a lot of stuff in it, but the stuff that's there was pretty good.
Yeah.
You know, it's like you get on certain films, you wish you had more, and you got something small, and then the films that, you know, didn't turn out so good, you wish you had, you know, it's just one of those things. It's the grass is always greener kind of thing, but it's hard to say. I haven't really thought of it like that, you know, like what's my favorite or what's my favorite film. There's different moments. Every film has its challenges, you know.
Some of the effects and the props, are you able to just take them from the film sets or do you have to like steal them? How does that work?
If it's a film that I worked on, then and it's something I'm doing, usually I end up with whatever's left over at the end.
And you have some here?
Well, I have some that are here. I didn't steal them. I didn't necessarily work on the films, but we acquired them.
Okay.
But we acquired them legally. No, but we did. But I've got major film props like from the movie Pacific Rim,
mm-hmm.
Resident Evil 4. From Jurassic Park 3, we have one of the egg hatchers that, the only one in the film that's not smashed. They go back to the island and they're looking at everything. And the only one that's not smashed, we've got that here. We've got some things from Hunger Games. We've got props from other movies. And we don't put a name tag on and say this came from Jurassic Park, but the stuff's there and if people can kind of look out for it, they might see it.
You know, for the first timer here, you know, what should they expect out of this haunt?
They should expect a cacophony of sights and sounds.
Ooh, and the word. Okay.
Yeah, cacophony. That's kind of a good word, but that's sort of what it is. We try to overwhelm the senses. So we try to have monsters hitting you from different angles. We try to have things so there's always something to look at. There's always something unexpected. You know, you might be afraid you're going to get eaten by a big monster, something like that, you know. But my goal in this is just to kind of overwhelm the senses.
I've been through a lot of haunted houses, and we went through it with Bill's much better half, Stacy. And I know you've been to your share. What did you think?
It was fantastic. It was the best one I've ever been to.
Honest, how many scenes?
It was
endless.
Longest. Yeah.
I mean, these people are crazy. And there was so much to see. And I give it a double thumbs up. I really love
it. Highly recommend.
I'm telling you, scream13.com. It's right here in Portage Lakes in Akron. And this David, oh my goodness. It really is worth the trip. I loved it.